Jessie P starts her little her Christmas feast a little bit early. There's no other guest within 50 miles, and Jessie's eating a hot dog.
Here's your treat.
Oh. I walked right into that one, didn't I?
What is that, a karaoke?
So you want one for?
Yeah. there's a steel post that go right through the middle of the store. Red head on it.
Into the edge of it, the end of it.
They go up and down this way. And he just ran face into it.
You like that?
My brother, somebody that works.
Roger, who's your tailor?
But you got nothing to laugh about, brother.
That's his eating clothes.
We just no lace and shoes.
But you know lace and shoes sell.
Christmas dinner looking like some rap artist.
I don't have anything to eat, bro. And if I choose to rap, I can rap.
Okay, that
guy's like a
fashion.
The shirt and pants don't go together?
Not really, but it doesn't matter to me either.
Then don't say nothing. Back to you that said something. What's wrong with them?
I didn't say it.
I was looking at her.
Why is yours out here?
Because I put it by yours. Because that's how I know where it was.
If you got one like that, old style lamp.
Oh, that's pretty. Thank you.
Sorry, I didn't say it to him.
help you?
Bet. Say, my grandpa's the one with the big nose.
Turning, but it'll run.
next year. Ready?
Dirt?
Oh, just watch on the news. Gavin, go get the football. Go get the football.
What? I hit you like that.
Hello.
Hello.
Yes? You came to say?
Nothing.
He didn't drop his cracker, though.
It's a cracker,
salvage
okay?
The food. Salvage the food.
It's a cracker, okay?
Was it a tea cake? Because I don't think they'll bend. They do it on my
plate. It's a chip. It's a chip.
Mom's trying to do the cheerleading pyramid thing.
I guess they're going to have to go to Barrett because he's not moving.
And the next thing you know, they'll all be doing this.
Barrett, you have to get up here too. Hop on, Gavin.
Can't do it that
way.
Is Dan getting on top?
Gus isn't no. Liking this room.
That looks like a lot of fun.
Oh, God.
Gus, quit screaming.
Oh, God. Poor Gus.
Thanks for letting me get a picture of you, Gus.
Let Grandpa run. Everybody get a chance.
It was a dumb picture.
Gus.
It was not. It was a good picture because you were in it. And Gavin was in it. That made it a good picture. I'm going to get him to treat the teacher.
Here he comes.
Barrett looks
Well, they learn a lot on the football field, didn't they?
Got on those pumps.
You You're not going to kick, are you?
She's got the same tailor as Roger's got.
Oh, a perfect spiral and nobody saw it.
Sure
was.
I did.
Y'all didn't.
Show.
That was a good one.
I don't want to take away from your outfit or I'd add
like
to mine.
I'd like to hear y'all karaoke.
Did
you know that Stacy was a professional karaoke at one time? Karaoke, except she's not y'all singer. That's what she did.
Get her on the machine.
That's what she did every Friday night for like 2 years.
Are you serious?
Can you karaoke?
On now.
Can you karaoke?
No.
Stacy.
You're going to.
Every Friday night for 2 years.
I'm the only one here with any talent.
Get back, maybe I'll
You heard me singing Footloose.
You need to get out of there so I can get
Is that new?
What?
Gotta get a few warm up swings.
Thank you in
the
picture of my sheep.
Perfect. It'll never happen again.
There's the sheep.
Oh, nobody cares. Since forever.
That's a long time.
Jessie, whatever you do, Jessie, don't let it hit you in the face.
Put your eye out.
Jessie was while ago. She was way on up there before I even knew it.
It's a contest. Who'll get higher? Who breaks their arm in most places?
Dan, see if there are any shingles missing.
Okay.
Because there's one on the ground.
Yeah, there's one right here, up here.
Okay.
The third one from the fall. There's one over there.
Dan is 400 feet off the ground.
There's three.
Are you going to jump over to the roof?
Nope.
Gavin, I'll sing Jingle Bells.
Come and get me, Barry. I'll help you.
Come on, it ain't working.
Your mic on?
Testing. It is still working.
And he's smaller. Step right up, folks, and I'll guess your weight. You, four eyes with a curly gray hair. Wonder and wake your fat old husband up and tell him to come out here.
Hey, Dan.
Yeah.
You know how to turn the mic up?
Yes, did you say mic volume?
Oh, we already did that.
Wake that fat man up in the rug with the batter in there and let him guess his weight. And the stars.
Looks like that wind chime singing. That's all I get.
You need the words to go with it.
What can I do for you?
Jingle bell, rock and roll.
Jingle bell, rock and roll.
Jingle bell, rock and roll.
Sing jingle bells.
It's a long music.
The ultimate challenge is make him sing with another song playing in the background.
He's singing what they're singing.
Yeah, but...
Turn the tape down.
Yeah. I mean, what's your name? Gavin, that's right.
He said it like
you gotta get real close like this.
I'm just gonna get...
Look at the camera.
Sing a little jingle bells, won't you?
Turn this one.
We need him facing the camera.
Jingle bells, jingle bells. Jingle bells, jingle bells. Jingle all the way. What fun it was. Dashing
through the snow. And one for the world. Sing loud, Gavin.
Let us tip it up so it's pointing at his mouth. Yeah.
Jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to watch
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way.
We're rocking now, Mama.
Wonder what we're saying.
Come on, man, let's sing some more. Let's sing, come here, let's sing Mickey Mouse.
Yeah, that's your son.
What's that song called?
Yay, Gavin.
Get Barrett to sing
Jingle
Bells.
Barrett, come here, let's sing. Come here, let's sing.
Come on. Okay, please.
Come down here.
Sometimes you get sidetracked.
He's gonna make an entrance. Come on, let's sing. Come on up here. And here he comes, ladies and gentlemen, the world's shortest midget. Gonna sing a little song for you called
Jingle Bells.
Jingle Bells.
Jingle Bells.
Put him on the other knee so we can sing.
The words
okay,
well.
You can eat the mic.
Yay!
Jingle bell. Jingle bell. Jingle all the way. Oh, what fun. And a one horse.
Louis Armstrong's grandson.
Yay! Barrett!
Thank you very much.
Excited kid in the back.
You're my kind of woman.
No.
I'm your kind of man. Baby, that's the reason it got so out of hand. Jerry Stewart for y'all, country western fans.
Musicians don't climb trees and remain.
Well, if you wasn't planning on moving, you might ought to think about it now. Don't ask this girl who painted her fingernails.
Stand up straight, Jessie.
Today on Comedy Corner, we have Jessica Phillips with her blonde jokes and her bubble pants.
And her,
take it away.
And her happy attitude.
Okay. There's a brunette and a blonde, and the brunette's driving. And the brunette says, oh no, there's a cop behind me. Tell me.
It's my husband.
Tell me, are his lights flashing? And the blonde looks back and says, yes, no, yes, no, yes, no.
Could you run it back?
The crowd is going wild! Here's the brunette in question.
Okay, there's a brunette. There's a brunette and a blonde.
Got it.
And the brunette is driving.
Right.
Oh no.
The brunette says, oh no, there's a cop behind me.
Right.
She says, tell me, are his lights flashing?
Got it.
And the blonde looks back and says, yes, no, yes, no, yes, no.
Okay. Bada boom.
Boom. Okay. What's the sound? Vroom, vroom, vroom,
I don't know.
It's a blonde driving through an intersection at a blinking red light. Okay. There's these three girls and... is a brunette, a redhead, and a blonde. And they're vacationing in Mexico. And and they're on the roof of the hotel, and all of a sudden the hotel catches on fire. And so everyone's evacuated except for these three girls. And so the Mexican fire department brings out their trampoline that they catch people with, and they call up to the brunette and say, "Go ahead, jump. We really love brunettes." And she says, "Are you sure?" And they say, "Yeah, go ahead, jump." And so she jumps, and when she's about to hit the trampoline, they pull it away and say, "Olé," and she falls on the street and dies. And so they call up to the redhead and say, "We were just lying. We don't like, we hate brunettes, but we really, really love redheads." She says, "Are you sure?" And they say, "Yeah, go ahead, jump." And so she jumps, and when she's about to hit the trampoline, they pull it away and say, "Olé," and she falls on the street and dies. And they call up to the blonde and say, "We were just lying again. We don't like brunettes or redheads. But we really, 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 really love blondes."
Okay.
And she says, "Uh-uh. Put the trampoline down and back away."
Get Aunt Sharon to tell you her duck joke.
I don't get
Could y'all
that.
Sound like a few more people, please?
Come on, baby. Tell the duck joke.
Put the trampoline down and back away.
Hey, Jessie.
Well, she thinks, oh, it won't move if they put it down, so.
She's going to jump.
On the ground.
I got one for you, Jessie.
She's going to jump on the trampoline that's on the
ground. Are you a blonde?
I don't get that. I guess so.
Because she's going to jump, okay, put the trampoline down, it ain't going to work.
It's okay, can I have your attention, wall. Please?
Hello? Hello?
We take this very seriously.
Hey, y'all know how to fix a woman's watch?
How to fix a woman's
An
watch?
An hour ahead?
You don't. There's a clock on the oven. Get it?
Okay, the duck comes into the bar, and the duck says, "Bartender, can I have a beer?" And the bartender says, "Well, you stupid duck. Ducks don't drink beer. Get out of this bar." So the next day, the duck comes back and he says, "Bartender, can I have a beer?" And the bartender says, "Oh, you stupid duck. You know you ducks don't drink beer. Get out of this bar. If you come back again, I'm going to nail your feet to the floor."
Here.
So the next day, the duck comes back into the bar and he walks up to the bar and he says, "Bartender, have you got any nails?" The bartender says, "No, I don't." The duck says, "Well, good. Give me a beer then."
Somebody go come swing with him.
Yeah,
I will.
I have
fell out a while ago, so don't let him do it again.
Okay, I have another, I have a last joke, but it's not a blonde. Okay.
Yeah. Good, because the blondes in the audience aren't getting the one for telling.
I was at the Whataburger with my friends, and we had gotten our burgers, and we sat down, and I went to the bathroom to wash my hands. And I come back, and my burger's not there. And I see a little old lady sitting at the table across from us. And I walk up to her and say, "Ma'am, I think you have my burger." And she looks at the wrapper and says, "Is your name Whataburger?" And I said, "No." And she says, "Then I don't have your burger." And so I go up to the manager and say, "Sir, that little old lady over there stole my burger." And he gives me one and says, "Here, it's on us." And I say, "Okay." So I go and sit down and eat my burger, and the little lady gets up to go to the restroom, and she has a little Brookshire's bag, and I say, "Oh, okay." So I go over there and take the bag, and she comes back and says, "I think you have my bag." And I said, "Is your name Brookshire's?" She says, "No." And I said, "Then I don't have your bag. You know what was in it?"
What?
A bunch of bull, just like I'm telling you right now.
Do it to me.
Do you know how to catch a polar bear?
Oh, don't.
Okay, I won't tell that one. Okay.
Somebody announced food and the audience left.
You cut a hole in the ice and you put peas around it. And the polar bear comes to take a pee, you kick him in the ice hole.
When that floor hit the floor.
Yeah, but I didn't knock
was
it down.
Was he asleep?
No, he was away.
What did he do then?
He got up, like, boing, and come set it back up.
Oh, did he make the little noise too?
No.
Who's that? Yet, Barrett.
What's that?
Not yet, Barrett.
Go, Dad. Barrett. Let him go.
Dad. Well,
okay. Take the paper off of it.
Where's Stacy go?
Just put it right there.
I'm gonna help you. I'm gonna help you. Let me get that string off, okay? Good. Now then. Take the paper off. Thank you. Barrett, come here and look at your present. Look at you.
Those are Jessie.
What's that, Gayla?
Look, Gavin, this is yours.
Maybe it was the big ones we were talking about.
Let's see here.
He was talking about the
these that cost $300? Stop.
Pay them out. Because I feel so bad in front of them.
Pay them out.
I lost one of my diamonds.
You put wheels on it.
Me. So I'm taking them
up to
my perfume.
It had Gavin's head in it.
Well, it's from Gavin.
It's dragging it even on them.
Did you get that made?
Really?
Thank you. I just thought for this.